Hi, I'm Laura Iles with the Iowa State University Plant and Insect Diagnostic Clinic, and today we're going to check out a pretty cool insect called oyster shell scale. So scale insects to me are always really weird because their name scale kind of is what they look like. They just look like little scales on the branches. That's actually the insect itself. The insect hatches from an egg. Very often the egg is held underneath the female's body. In the case of oyster shell scale, they overwinter as eggs underneath the female's body. The female's dead at that point. Her body's just protecting those eggs. And then in the spring, usually about late June, same time as lilac bloom, those eggs hatch into crawlers. And it's this crawler stage that can move around. And it's the crawlers that crawl out, find a different place than their mother did to settle down. So they settle down, they have a little piercing sucking mouth part that they pierce into the plant, and then they start forming that protective scale over their body. So the key is to notice oyster shell scale infestations early. So autumn blaze maple are really loved for their beautiful red fall coloration, but right now we're in July, and so this is not the time your tree should be turning red. The leaves should still be nice, beautiful, dark green right now. So get up closer, that's where we can actually see this scale insect. So again, that red coloration in July is not normal. It's a sign of stress for the tree. It's not specific just to oyster shell scale. It just means that the tree is under stress. But if you look there, like right there, scale insects, and they can just rip them off with your fingernail. But then you look at some of these other branches on the tree and it's completely coated in scale insects. That's all that you're looking at, is scale insects. Now these all could be several years old because they stay on the tree, the eggs just hatch from beneath the female. So these could be a few years old. So if you ever do, when you do scale treatments, when you use insecticides on those crawlers, you definitely want to come and check the new growth and make sure the new growth doesn't have scales. You will probably still have scale insects on the older growth. In this case, even the trunk of the tree has scales. Any contact insecticide labeled for scale insects, including horticultural oils and things like that, will work. Systemic insecticide, only a product containing dinotefuran would work. Imidacloprid, which is widely available, does not control these scale insects because they're just not feeding on a part of the plant where that insecticide gets to. So they're a challenge to control. So it really, you know, when you can prune out the scales, that's the best time. So again, watch, because it'll start with just a branch and then continue from there. How these insects spread around is to me amazing. Like, it's basically wind, and it's just the crawlers, those little babies that either can blow, and so the luck that they blow and happen to land on another host plant, or they kind of hitchhike on insects. So an ant crawling by, they might crawl onto the ant leg and then be moved elsewhere. Here we are on campus with a gray dogwood shrub. So from a distance, you can kind of see that this shrub has some parts that are fairly normal looking with green leaves. You have other parts where you're seeing the leaves kind of a little bit of a strange color, and then even some dead leaves. And once we got up close to this plant, we could see that all the branches and little branches and these dead branches are covered. Oyster shell scale attacks about 130 different species of plants, so lots of different things in the landscape can be affected by oyster shell scale. Luckily in this case, because this is a shrub, we're able to prune it back, and pruning out the oyster shell scale, literally removing those branches, is a good management method.